Hi everyone, and welcome to this session on JMeter beginner tutorial. So this is the fourth series of this tutorials, and in the initial series we saw how to download and install JMeter on Windows and a Mac, and how to create a test plan and how to create a very simple performance test on a web application. Okay, so in this tutorial we will look about and talk about listeners. Okay, so what exactly are listeners in JMeter? So in very simple words, we can say that listeners are the elements of JMeter which gather the information about the test which is being executed. So these listeners provide us a way to look at the results and the metrics of our test. So when we create a test and when we run a performance test, obviously we would want to look at the results which will show us how did our application perform. Okay, so this is what listeners are all about. And let us go to our JMeter window, and we can see this is the test plan that we created in our first session, and we have renamed it as my first test plan. We have a thread group that we have renamed as users. And then we have a HTTP request sample, and we have renamed it as my homepage. We are doing a test on a website called lifecharger.org, and we are hitting a web page on this website. And if I go to the thread group, we are using 5 users, and the ramp up period is 1 second. So that means in a single second, 5 users will be generated. And the iteration is 1, so it will run for a single iteration per user. Okay, now if I right click on my thread group and go to add, and you can see listeners here, and we have all these different type of listeners available in JMeter. In this session we are going to look at the most commonly used and the most basic listeners. So let us start with view results in table. So you can see this listener has come here. So to see what does this listener contains, let us start my test by clicking on the start button. And soon we will see some data coming here. And yes, we have 5 request samples. And this is because we created this test with 5 users and a single iteration. Okay. So let us quickly understand what does this data means. The very first column is sample number, so the number of samples will come here. Then the second column is start time per request. Then if you see the third column, it is showing us users, 11 users, 13. What does this mean is users is coming from the name of our thread group, which is here, users. And 1 means this is the first iteration of user 1, this is the first iteration of user 3, this is the first iteration of user 5, first iteration of user 2, and so on. Have we given it 2 loops or 2 iterations, we would have found duplicate entries for every user, but because it is a single iteration, so we are getting a single entry per user. Okay, this is the label. Whatever label we are giving, it will be displayed here. This is the sample time in milliseconds, so that means the response time of this request is being displayed here in milliseconds. The status is mostly taken from assertion, so in case we put some assertion, if the assertion passes, it will be shown as green, otherwise it will be shown as red. Okay, but in this particular test plan I have not added any assertion, so in that case it will take defaults, and by default any response code of 200 which is pass and okay will be displayed as green, and any other response code like 201 or something else will be termed as a failure and will be displayed as red here. Okay, this column is byte, so this is the size of the request, and because we are using a single request, so you can see the size is equal in every request. Then we have the latency. So this is again in milliseconds, but what exactly do we mean by latency? So latency is time to first byte. Okay, latency is time to first byte. And what does this actually mean is Let us suppose, let us take a scale of 0 milliseconds to, I'll take a scale from 0 to, let's say, 2000 milliseconds. Okay. Now, let us assume that our request started from here and it went until 1000 milliseconds, and after 1000 milliseconds we started getting the response. So let us say we started getting the response from 10 milliseconds. So we started getting response here and we got the complete response. By the time we got the complete response, it was 2010 milliseconds. Okay, let me say 2010 milliseconds. Okay, now let us understand what does this mean is, our request started here and it went to the server, and the by the time it the complete request went to the server, it was 1000 milliseconds, and by the time we started getting the response, it was 1010 milliseconds. So we started getting the response here. So this particular time is called as the latency time, when we started getting the first byte. But the response time is not this one. The response time is 2010 milliseconds. So this is the time when we got our complete response. Okay, so this is what latency means here. And this is the connect time. So connect time is the time our request took to connect to the server. Now this may be important in most of the cases because there is some, you know, activity happening while we are connecting to the server. There can be an SSL handshake with the server and we want to know that what is the time being taken in these kind of activities, so that based on these results we can optimize our application. Okay, so this is what view results in table listener looks like, and let me just note it down. The first listener we saw is view results in table. Let us go to our second listener, and that will be view results in tree. Okay, now let me start my application and my test again and see what is the data we are getting here. So you see, we are getting a tree structure here, and if I click on any of the request, I get some information here. So I get the response code, the message, and some headers, and you know, some other information. I can go to the request and I can see exactly what is the request that got to the server, and then I can see the response. So this is the source code of the page that was generated as the response of this request, right? So I can actually validate the request and see exactly the request and the response being received. So this is what view results in tree listener looks like. Okay, one important thing to notice here is view results in tree is a listener which takes up a lot of memory. So in case you want to set up a very heavy load or performance test, do not use this listener. You can use this listener initially to check that all your test is running fine, you are getting proper request and response from the server, and once you have validated that, you can disable or drop this listener and do not use it for a heavy load or performance test. Okay, let us look at some other listeners. So let us look at aggregate report. Let me run my test again and see what does the data looks like here. Okay, so you can see we have got a single line of response generated here. Okay, so in view results in table we had one line per request, but in aggregate report we have a single line. So the advantage here is it accumulates all the metrics and gives us a single line report where we have the number of samples. Now of course, because we had only one sampler, so we are getting just one line. So per sampler we will get a single line report, we are getting the average of all our requests. So this is the average time our request took. This is the median. Median is when we say 2856 milliseconds, that means half of the request took more time than this 2856 milliseconds, and half of the request took less time than this particular number. 90% line means 90% of the request took less than 2962 milliseconds, or 90% of the requests were within this range. 95% line means 95% of the requests were within the range of 3000 milliseconds, and 99% line means the same, that 99% of the requests were within 3000 milliseconds. Now if you look at 99% line and max, you can see this is equal, and most of the times you will find this equal, because when we say 99% were below 3000, which is equivalent to the max amount any request took. Okay, this is the minimum amount any request took. The error percentage, throughput is here it is showing 1.4 per second. So the number of requests per second is shown as throughput here, and this is the size per second which we got as a response. Okay, so this is what is an aggregate report in JMeter. Let us look at some other common listeners. Let us look at graph results. This is very interesting. So to actually look at, you know, the use of this graph results, let me increase my users and also make the iteration as forever. Okay, so let me execute it, and as our test will start, you can see there are some colored dots coming here in the graph. Okay, and you can actually see the key here. The green colored dots will be throughput, red colors are deviation, purple are median, then we have blue colored dots which is average, and then data is in black. Okay, and if you do not want to see some of the metrics, we can actually switch it off from here. I do not want to see data, I do not want to see median, and I do not want to see deviation. I just want to see average and throughput, and you can see this graph is getting generated real time. Okay, one important thing to notice here is you will most of the time see that when our test starts, the throughput is high and the average is low, but as our test progresses, you will see both of these lines coming closer and merging and even crossing each other. And that is obviously because as we hit the same request again and again, there is some cache being developed and the throughput goes high and the average response times comes lower. Okay, so this is how we can see the graph. Okay, and we can see the graph getting generated runtime. I'll close this. So this was our graph result. Okay, again important thing to notice is graph results are again a highly memory consuming listener. So if you are creating a very heavy load of performance test, please do not use this listener. Let us look at some other listener. Let us look at a summary report. Okay, so let me make it 1, make the users 5 again, and ramp up period is let's say 1, and I'll start my test. Now you can see we have got some data here in the summary report, and if we see the aggregate report, we can see it is very much common, and we can also see there are some parameters which are present in both of these reports. So in summary report, we are getting our label, we are getting the samples, total number of samples, then again we are getting the average. So in this we are not getting these 90% line, 95% lines which were there present in aggregate report. We will not be getting this here. We'll be getting the standard deviation here. We'll be getting the error percentage, throughput, average bytes and so on, right? So this is what a summary report looks like. Okay, so let us note it down here, summary report. Now one good thing in JMeter is, in most of these listeners, if you have noticed, there is a file name field here. Okay, so what you can actually do is you can give the path of some CSV or XML file here, and all the data of these listeners will get logged to that file runtime. Okay, so you can see all these have a file name here, so I can actually browse some particular file from my system. Okay, give it here, okay, and when will I'll run my test case, I will see that my file will get all the data which is there present in this listener. Okay, so this is the advantage that you do not have to copy paste from here every time. You can directly log the results to a file. Okay, let us see another listener, and let me say simple data writer. Okay, now this is interesting. Let us say this is 6th. Okay, now this listener, you do not have any UI, you just have a box where you can browse your file. So let me say I want to log my results to this file. Okay, so what it will do is it will log the results in a tabular form in this particular file, and you have the configuration button here where you can configure how do you want to log the results. So for example, I do not want to save the field names, I can click here and other things, and I can say done. Okay, now when I will run this test and I go to my file, now you can see this is the file and it has logged some data. And if I open the file, I think there is some old data. Let me first clear all the data from here and save this file. So now this file should be empty. Okay, I run my test again and let me see the file now. So yes, it just got some data now, and if I open it, so yes, now I can see all my data here. Okay, so all the data that was present in the table in other listeners is getting logged to my file here. Okay, so this is what a simple data writer is all about. And whenever we are running a very heavy load test or a performance test, it is recommended that we do not use any of these UI listeners and we only use simple data writer, so that we the memory is not consumed in presenting the data to the listeners and, you know, presenting the data in a UI form. The other advantage is that we can actually start our JMeter from a command line. We do not have to come to this UI every time, and we just have to give the location of our result file where the results will be logged. So you do not have to open the JMeter UI, and we can run all our tests from command line, and in the coming sessions we will look how exactly we do that. Okay, so in this session, this was all about JMeter listeners. Hope you like it. Thank you.